Hey guys, Drifter here. Today I want to talk about the future of Warzone because I believe that it's on a very bad trajectory right now. And that trajectory isn't toward the game being dead, but probably significantly smaller and less relevant than it currently is. The gameplay is, of course, me playing Warzone and actually having quite a bit of fun. I got some games in with fellow Carnage Clan member Deeper Jungle, and we just had a blast playing, but unfortunately that doesn't happen every time, or really even the majority of the time. Warzone can be an incredibly frustrating game, and I don't think I'm the only content creator that feels this way because I've noticed a lot of big streamers and content creators recently moving on to other games. As a matter of fact, Exclusive Ace made a video about this topic with an extremely similar title to mine, and his came out just a few hours before I sat down to record this commentary. So I promise you I didn't steal it from him. I think it's more of an idea of great minds think alike, perhaps convergent strategies, convergent design that happens sometimes. We cover the same stuff, some of the same topics come up over and over again, so that's kind of normal. But I did watch his video, it was interesting. He actually had an idea and a point that I did not, so I'll talk about one of his ideas a little bit later in this video. But yeah, Warzone is showing signs of decline for the first time, like maybe ever, and I genuinely believe that the player base for the mode is shrinking. It's getting smaller. Unfortunately, this isn't because other games are better or newer or like a big release came out to steal players, but rather it's because Warzone is in such a really bad shape at the moment, and I think when new big games do come out, like Battlefield or X-Defiant or Halo Infinite, that tons of gamers that have just been waiting to jump ship to some new big AAA game that has anti-cheat are going to do exactly that and just leave Warzone and its Hackerfest behind forever. So today's video has two parts. Number one is what I'm noticing with the trend of this game, and number two is why I think people are leaving. So number one, I've noticed that Twitch viewership for Warzone has been declining over the last couple of weeks. I sometimes see it hovering around 8th to 9th place, though I would say 4 to 6th place is most common, but almost never first anymore. It's just kind of slowly getting lower and lower on those Twitch rankings, and the numbers are getting smaller. This is hard a perfect predictor of player-based numbers, but it's a good trend indicator. If you see a game declining in Twitch viewership, typically the player base is going to decline slowly after that, which would kind of be now, the beginning of the decline. It's a very similar story with YouTube and TikTok and Twitter and other things. The content creators just kind of aren't really feeling it. Well, that's being generous. Lots of content creators are completely crapping on Warzone right now, not just with videos like this one that are somewhat measured and reserved, but just savagely trashing this game on Twitter and other social media, and then going to stream something else regardless of how successful said Warzone stream could have been. I personally have noticed a lot less of my friends playing Warzone. When I log on, there's just less people on my friends list on, or if I pull people in, they have a much greater reluctancy to play. They're kind of like, you don't want to do anything else. There's some other game, that game has hackers, blah, blah, blah. And I know that my friends list is small and it's a bunch of mostly pretty elite gamers, so it's probably not the best sample, but it's a trend that I notice. And another trend that I notice that isn't an exact science is that my lobbies are getting weirder. There seems to be greater skill gaps in each lobby that I play in, with more bad players than before and more really good sweaty teams. So before, the lobbies would more or less put me where most players were of my skill level, with a few somewhat higher, or if I played with really competitive people, there'd be a bunch of really competitive people. But I think that the skill-based matchmaking algorithm is having a hard time getting enough people together for matches now, so it's loosening the bands and allowing for wider acceptable matches. So I'm fighting people that are significantly less talented than me and running into some god squads that are a couple of steps above where I normally play. Again, not a perfect sample, but just something I have noticed, and a declining player base would kind of explain this algorithmic shift in player skill levels. Since the entire video is opinions today, let's move on with my opinion about why people are leaving Warzone. The number one reason is hackers, 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 cheaters, hackers, VPNs, console hacks, and did I mention hackers? Warzone has been plagued with hackers for 16 months now. That's over a year. I could generously call it a year and a half of playing this game mode, and the hacking hasn't gotten any better since day one. If anything, it's actually gotten worse over time. I will admit that the hacking waves are somewhat inconsistent. Sometimes I'll have a good couple of days of playing with no hackers, and then some other time I'll just play and it's hackers all night long, every lobby, every other lobby. And there's always the suspicion that I or somebody else may have been shadow banned, or maybe we are suspected to be hackers and we're put into lobbies with other hackers. Or if you play with somebody really good and their stats are really good, it matches against other high stat people, which are probably going to be hackers. And it's very inconsistent. I can't seem to quite get a feel for it. other than the fact that it feels bad when I die to hackers. And I have never in my entire life seen a AAA game left so totally defenseless against hackers. Warzone is like a turtle on its back baking in the sun right now, and the sun is people just running hack farms out of China and Russia. It is just ridiculous how defenseless the game is, how little can be done. There's ban waves that do nothing. They can't even detect most of the cheats, even still. There are people that have been cheating since day one and just have never been caught. There are people that sit down and stream themselves cheating on Twitch all day, every day, and have tons of fans watching. And even when Activision does ban them, they just make a new account and keep going. They just ban them on Twitch and just make a new account on Twitch and just kind of keep going. There are people streaming major tournaments, like $100,000 tournaments, having to get called or redone or canceled because people are hacking in them. Blatantly hacking, which is so stupid to do because it will ruin your career. I understand the temptation to get more money to win one of these $100,000 tournaments because that could be life-changing money, but it just totally destroys any opportunity of a future career that that person could have. But the hacking is so prevalent in Warzone, and there's so many cheats and so many of them that are easy to conceal, that a lot of these gamers just seem to think that's an okay thing to do. Speaking of careers, the up-and-coming YouTuber Bad Boy Beeman has made an entire career out of exposing hackers, or really just calling people out and accusing them of hacks, and just basically taking this hack issue and beating that dead horse into a pulp, and then refining that pulp and selling dead horse pulp smoothie to his subscribers. All about hacks. He's created an entire sub-industry, an entire small business just to complain about hackers. It's not even the scale to think about. You have a man who makes his full-time living on a YouTube channel just complaining about hacks is smaller than the people selling the hacks in China. That's a $100 million business, if you believe the more recent lawsuits. There are days where maybe a third to half of my lobbies are just ruined by hackers, and it's gotten to the point where it's turned me into a legitimately toxic and salty gamer, such that anytime somebody aims well or kind of seems to know where I'm at or just plays really well, I kind of blame hacks. On one hand, it's kind of a joke. It's kind of a funny thing to do to the audience. You know, anybody that's better than me is clearly hacking. But then on the other hand, there's a little bit of truth to it because the hacks are getting so subtle now, it's quite difficult to tell. And it's really, really outrageous that I or anyone else have managed to play Warzone for this long with this many hackers. And this little, I'm beating a dead horse again. I'm selling my own dead horse pulp smoothies, but it doesn't even touch on VPNs, bot lobby strategies, and the upcoming console hacks. There's so much you could talk about here. And the issue is that there's no fix on the horizon. There's no promised solution, no anti-cheat announcement, no big changes coming, nothing in the works that I'm aware of that they're just gonna roll out in a couple of months or weeks or whatever to fix this problem. For the most part, it's radio silence on Activision's end. They do announce ban waves that do very little. You might have less hackers for a day, but when they wake up on the other side of the world, they're just going to make other accounts and get right back at it. Regular gamers don't enjoy dying to hackers any more than pro streamers. It's just not fun. It ruins the game for all types of gamers. If you're streaming and trying to entertain people, it's miserable to get killed by a hacker. If you have worked a full 10, 12-hour shift and you come home and you want to sit down and play a couple of games of COD, it is depressing to get smashed by a hacker. It's frustrating. It takes your little bit of fun away because the game should make you feel happy. It should be fun to play, not give you clinical depression after the 7th hacker death in one night. The next problem is that there have been no major changes to the core gameplay of Warzone. We got new locations on the map. We did get Rebirth Island, which has been changed up a bit. We got new loot. We got new guns. We got zip lines. We got a lot of new guns, a lot of changes to the gun meta, gun balance, gun strategies. JGod made an entire sub-industry basically going over Warzone gun changes because there were so many in that regard, and we're at a good meta right now. But in terms of core gameplay mechanic changes, basically nothing. There's no new abilities, there's no new movement strategies that weren't already in the game. People are still working on mastering it, but no, you know, nothing new. There's no mantle slide technique, there's no advanced climbing, there's no changes to vehicles, no real changes to armor other than that we got the satchel quite a long time ago. No changes to explosives, bullets, no changes to the economy or the looting system other than just new things to buy. So by and large, Warzone is the same game that it was a year and a half ago, but it's been improved upon or just a lot more content, or really just a ton more content. They added a ton of content in terms of skins and cosmetics and guns. They added a ton of weaponry to the mode. They've added a bunch of new pickups, and they've added some map locations and stuff. But those kind of changes aren't really like core gameplay changes. They're not like Fortnite level game changers where they just upended everything and went with this kind of crazy stuff. So even if the new maps have been slightly less than new, they've still been fun, they've been modified. If the new guns haven't changed the entire dynamic, I've still enjoyed them, but they've kind of bought time for something big to happen, but that big thing doesn't appear to be happening anytime soon. Every time you drop into Verdansk, it's the exact same thing that it was a year and a half ago. You loot up as fast as humanly possible, get a loadout with the best stuff that you possibly can, and then you're going to race to kill as many people as humanly possible, because you can't plan on winning, because you're probably going to run into a hacker somewhere along the way. But hey, you had fun, you got 12 kills, you know, you had a couple of good gunfights. And that's pretty much what Warzone has been for a long time, and that hasn't changed. And I feel like that they could use a significant change to their gameplay loop to spice it up and keep players interested, because I think a lot of people are kind of getting bored with it, and they're kind of looking at Battlefield and just saying, ooh, I wonder what's going on over there. Another big issue is that optimization on this game is still rough after being out for more than a year. The game is rough on PC, which is where I play, and I have a monster PC. I have a 3090, I have an i9, I have a whole second PC just for streaming, so I don't have to use any of my system resources for it. And it still barely runs right. It still struggles all the time. It crashes. Consoles still don't have FOV sliders, so they're kind of at a disadvantage, but they're still forced to play with PC players, which means wider field of view and more hackers. The consoles have crashes, PC has crashes, memory leaks, dev errors. There was a time where we had Cronenberg guns for a long time. Invisibility glitches is very common, or invincibility, or below the map, or whatever. And when it comes to Warzone, there is always something that is either totally broken or game-breaking. There is just always some kind of very significant glitch to abuse, and very little time where that isn't the case. And finally, I believe that change is on the horizon. Summer is ending with lots of family vacations going on right now. I'm sitting at home being a loser. I'm trying to recover my health enough to be able to actually take a vacation. Then school is going to be starting up, both high school and college. Some people will be returning to work for the first time after being vaccinated. Lots of younger players are leaving behind Warzone for their last taste of outside fun, a late spring break, a summer vacation, something like that, before the Delta variant goes completely cuckoo crazy and we all have to lock down again. I assume that most of you have seen the coronavirus numbers. They're not looking good. I think it's going to be a long, boring, shut-in winter of lockdowns again, especially if you live in Florida. Good luck, guys. So given all of the above frustrations, I don't think that when these people come back from their work, from their school, from their college or vacations or whatever, that they're really going to want to jump back into Warzone and get frustrated with hackers and basically kind of the same gameplay. And on the same token, there's lots of huge new FPS titles dropping soon, the biggest of which is Battlefield 2042. EA came out absolutely just blowing everything out of the water with this trailer. It looks super fun. I think that's what most gamers are hyped about. There's X Defiant, which a lot of people want to play but are a little skeptical about. Halo Infinite has basically all of the old Halo fanboys and Xbox fanboys going crazy. There will be a new multiplayer COD. I don't think a lot of people are going to move to that one. You've got Far Cry 6, you've got Back 4 Blood coming, which is like the unofficial sequel to Left 4 Dead. And there's tons of good things going on, and that's just in the FPS genre. And the gaming genre in general is gearing up for a pretty big fall. And pretty much any of these games are guaranteed to be fun and also not filled with hackers. I think that that's just something you're not going to have to deal with in most of these games. And I think that content creators will jump ship too, because new games is easy views, which is easy money. And at the end of the day, content creators like me and whoever else that you watch on this platform are essentially running small businesses, and they do have bills to pay, so they can't upload content that people don't want to watch. They have to upload something that's reasonably popular and doesn't drive them crazy. And in the case of Warzone, that's going to be neither. Warzone's going to decline in popularity, and it's going to drive them crazy because the anti-cheat's not going to be there. It's just still going to be chaos. So they're going to move on, and they're going to upload something else, and one or two of these games, I think, is going to kind of blow up, and Warzone is going to become second, third, or fourth fiddle. Maybe a fifth wheel might be a way to say it. So personally, I think I'm kind of hitting some Warzone burnout for all of the reasons above. I quit the game for a while, I think it was a week or two, and then I came back and made some content, then I stopped playing again, then I came back, and I'm kind of trying to get back into the swing of it and have fun, but it really hasn't been doing it for me lately. I think that basically the hacker frustration is just driving me crazy, and after a year and a half, it's just enough. I don't think that I'm going to be super into Warzone until changes are made. I'll still probably play it and do patches and cover it here, but it's not something I'm super passionate about, because I can't die to like a wall hacking aimbot for the 500th time and be happy about it. So until some major changes come, I think that Warzone is going to continue to decline, and I think the future of Warzone is looking very rough. I wish that wasn't the case. I wish I had some, like, more positive thing to make a video about today, but it's really the number one thing on my mind, more than meta, more than patches, more than new stuff coming out. It's just that gamers are getting frustrated with this, and they're getting ready to jump ship. Guys, that is all for this video. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe. Drifter out.